8 days. I mean 9 days. We are trying to improve our qualities of speaking English. Teachers are being advised and guided differently. And what qualities are developed with the help of this training that will be evaluated on 5th December, I mean on Monday, isn't it? And your group, your advice for that which schools we are going to evaluate teachers. So, with this training, in this training, what are the good qualities of a good speaker? What are the qualities of good speakers? Those qualities, those features will be evaluated, will be checked with your performances. So it is expected that all the activities, all the expected contents, whatever are discussed here in the class, you have to utilize, you have to use those in your actual demonstration of lesson, in your class, isn't it? So you are checking yourselves. So it's not a be free. First of all, don't take any type of burden for that. Be free, prepare yourself and give a demo. It will be happy and having positive attitude. Don't check others. Don't criticize others. To whom you are going to observe, to whose lesson you are going to observe, you need not to criticize him. We are going to give him a chance, an opportunity to improve it. So don't lose your confidence. Just be with full of positive attitude and full of positive confidence. Okay. So now, what good qualities a teacher must have? Those points are covered here in this topic, in evaluation. First point, you see that what is expecting. When you are in a class, at the time, you are not only checking the performance of teacher, but you are also checking the performance of students. First of all, keep in mind. So, observer has to check the performance of teacher and performance of students simultaneously, instantly, in the same lesson. Okay. Now, what is this? Manage the activity. The first point is there, intelligibility. Intelligibility is what? Intelligibility means understanding. Your speaking skill, your pronunciation should be internationally intelligible. It will be understood internationally. Such type of pronunciation you must have, isn't it? So, whatever you speak, which language you use in a class, all that points, the language, must be understood by your students. Whether teachers are using that language or not, you have to observe it, you have to check it. So, there are 5 points that you are there. No response, miss improvement, satisfactory intelligibility, good response, and excellent. You have to give the grades to the teachers. So first point is intelligibility. I explained this point that you must speak, your pronunciation must be clear and intelligible. Means easy to understand. Easy to understand. Every listener must understand your pronunciation, isn't it? So that is intelligibility. So proper pace. Whatever steps you are using, you are adopting in your lesson, whether the teacher has followed the steps, proper steps or not, that one should be covered in paces. Okay? Proper pace. Yes. Whatever the steps, when there is a lesson, we have to make a lesson plan for that, right? With that lesson plan, we are delivering the lesson. So, whether the teacher has followed the proper steps in the lesson or not, you have to check it. Maybe. Harvard's principle is not an English. But whatever you mean, you know, we are experienced teachers. What is expected from the teacher? You know, you may judge it, speak it in the proper box. Okay, next point is fluency. Keep in mind that what is expected? We are trying to maintain the fluency and not accuracy for the learners. For the learners, it's most important point. Accuracy is important features of language, accuracy. But for the learners, it is neglected. For the learners, if we insist on accuracy, then learners hesitate to speak. Learners hesitate to speak, they avoid speaking in a group, they avoid speaking in a society. So, first of all, try to think for fluency and not for the accuracy. Okay, you got it. So, fluency must be there in speakers, in teachers, teaching, in teachers, talking, isn't it? Next point is confidence. Need not to explain this point. You know all these things. When confidence builds up, when you have prepared yourself well, when you have practiced your lesson well, isn't it? When you have studied, when you have tried different techniques of speaking, afterwards your confidence will be boosted, isn't it? Afterwards. So, to increase your confidence, whether the teacher's confidence is built up or not, you have to check it and you have to understand it. Then you may use a proper team for that.